Welcome to the Montreux Jazz. How's it going?
Great.
And have you been here before? Is this the first time?
I was here when I was a kid with a goat farmer.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
And how long ago was that?
I was like this tall, so you can calculate yourself maybe.
Danish lineup here at the Jazz Café tonight. Are you guys aware of the other two groups you're playing with? Do you know them?
Yeah, we know. Really good groups, both of them. I really like them.
God, he's a rolling stone. He left me in this mess all alone. Man, if I just knew the plan, I would let it go and surely understand. Yeah. I feel like Moses on the mountain, waiting for the truth to be delivered, waiting for the sky to open up. Yeah, I feel like Moses at the dead end, waiting for the truth to be delivered, waiting for someone to lead the way. Some air, it's exactly not enough to get me out of here. Oh, if only I knew what dragged me so deep down below. Mountain, I feel like Moses on a mountain, waiting for the truth to be delivered, waiting for the sky to open up. Dead end, I feel like Moses at a dead end, waiting for the sea to be divided, waiting for someone to lead the way.
Just like that. You guys were saying you like to do things differently. You definitely have a different history to most groups. You guys are voted one of the top five live acts in China. Now you guys are huge there because you formed in Shanghai, right? Tell me a bit about the scene over there and what it's like being big in China.
Well, what I really liked about China and about music in general is when you're able to merge groups that usually don't belong together, like for example, if we can get a lot of metal hits and a lot of pop chicks go to the same concert, it would be a beautiful moment, all these people appreciating the same thing. And what we did in China was actually, we sort of had an appeal to both the punk rockers, the local punk rockers, and the exchange students, the expats, the businessmen from Europe and stuff. So we had all the angry kids and all the people who lucrated on the angry kids and their families go to the same concerts and appreciate the very same thing, and it was kind of huge, I would say.
We'll be right back.
what was your favorite part of China? Because I imagine you saw quite a bit of it, being able to tour through the country.
My favorite part of China, the girls, maybe. The girls are my favorite part of China.
And you're from Denmark. The girls from Denmark are known to be absolutely beautiful. So you already got it made in Denmark.
Yeah, that's true.
And so how is it different there? Do you guys prefer playing like in China than to in Denmark?
It's really different. Like the music culture and the music history is so different, like Denmark and China compared. Like for instance, we used to say that China, they got like Michael Jackson and, you know, Winnie Hu at the same time. I don't know if Winnie Hu is like, if they listen to Winnie Hu in China, but as well as they got the Hives and Black Sabbath on the same, like, same period of time. So the, or ABBA and Lady Gaga. It's like, to them, there's like, they don't have the historical difference.
Right.
And that's pretty special. So everything's really mixed up. And they also, I think what we've learned is that they really appreciate new things because they're not so used to being, they're not used to getting these things. It's pretty new to them that that China's opening up to the Western world. And I think you can feel that in your audience. Like, for instance, when if I crowd surf or something like that, it's like it's really new to them. It's pretty fresh. Whereas in Denmark, it's like it has a history of like 50 years. But in China, you can, in some ways, it's like a blue ocean. You can do things that hasn't really been done before.